using mouse events and keyboard events, there are a number of possible methods. But while implementing or for a particular application usage, only the particular function is need to enable or describe the, or define the same. But remain same must be empty, like it must be defined over the function. You cannot leave the same. So for that purpose, we need to it requires extra space and time waste also. But in order to avoid the same, this adapter class provides an empty implementation implicitly. So no need to explicitly define whatever the function we did not define the same. So that is the purpose of this adapter class. So that's why they are representing like when you defining or implementing the interface over the class, Java class, all the methods must be defined explicitly. That is the one way to use the same. So in order to over here, but this adapter class, if any class extends from this adapter class in the sense, always provide that null implementation over all the methods belong to that, except the which are all going to define explicitly over the same. So that is the purpose of the same. So it includes three major classes: key adapter, mouse adapter, mouse motion adapter. These are the three classes most commonly used under this adapter class. So we'll see the demo with the following Java coding. So initially the necessary packages are added to demonstrate the same. So this class name, like adapter demo, going to describe the adapter class usage. This adapter demo extends to the most adapter. So this program going to describe the how the mouse adapter can be handled in this frame. So within the frame, within the main function, frame is created with the object graph, with the caption mouse adapter sample. The size of the frame is going to save with these two parameters, like and it is 300 comma p, and frame is enabled here. Then in this class, object is created. Then mouse motion listener, this motion listener added here. So what is the purpose of this listener? This is going to observe whatever the mouse event happened over this frame window. That is the purpose of this. So F represents the object. The along with the object, this listener, mouse listener is added to this object. So that is the, so always it's going to listen while executing that application, whatever the events of over the same. Then when pressing the mouse, it's going to display like mouse pressed. So we have a number of other function also, like mouse please click, mouse move, mouse press release. So some other function also is there, but we didn't define anything within along with this mouse pressed function, because we have used here the mouse adapter. So implicitly it's defined as the null function. So only the I'm defining the string while mouse pressing press. While mouse press only it's going to display like press. Otherwise it won't display any other message. So this we will see over the output function. So this function's output is displayed here. The output of this function is displayed here. It shows like mouse press. So while executing this particular Java application, it says like mouse press. Whenever I press it, like I press continuously, in the sense it will display like mouse press. Whenever I release it, it may stop to display like mouse press. So this this model doesn't have any interfaces to handle the same. So this, whatever the inputs given by the user through the buttons or labels or some or all the components, it's going to handle the same. Then we need to display the components over the screen. So whatever the data passed through the model by the user, it will be displayed over the wheel. So it's going to through this wheel component only you can visibly or externally see the components over the screen. The third one is controller. So controller, whatever the events it may receive, it's going to handle the same and also pass to the again pass to the model. So that is the purpose of this controller. So it will handle the, so that's why it is called as the handling the inputs. Whatever the things data was maybe passed through the model, that is passed via the beam to the controller. So it handle and again it will update the same into the model. So that is the purpose of the this controller. So each one is dependent on each other, like model, wheel, controller. So model depends on wheel. So wheel going to handle the whatever it receives and send to the controller. The controller again send to the model. So each one is dependent on each other. So the structure of the MVC, like model, wheel, controller is displayed here. So as like model, the process model has its own data. Like for example, choice. Whatever the choice provided by the user are listed under the model. Based on this example, this will handle the choice. So it may be the list or checkbox or label or button. Whatever the data passed with its component, it will consider as model. Then that is passed to the wheel. So how it, this choice can be handled? So that's that comes under this wheel component. So this how it is accepting the input, that is maintained by the controller. This is part of the controller. It's going to accept the input given by the user, maybe mouse click or keyboard or input, so anything that is handled by this controller. So model, wheel, controller. So based on these we can select the particular choice from the list. Like I have n number of choice. So among these choice I can select, anyone can select the particular option, CSE, triple E, EC and X. So from this anyone can select. So for anyone to select the same, these three controller will, these three options will work for the same. So this structure defines the same. So the combination of these three only will get the particular option immediately. The next topic is MVC interaction. So how these three are interacting in order to select the particular event or option. So model, wheel, controller. So model, whatever the input gets from the user with the corresponding components they are going to receive, and then if the same to be passed to the wheel in order to rendering the same. Rendering this is in order to change over the same. Whatever the modification need to do that with the help of user. So for that purpose only it's going to pass the message to the wheel. So we are going to analyze and whatever it's going to determine which of the events should be passed to the controller. So we can have n number of events. So at a particular current situation, which are all the current instance, which are all the events are selected, that must be passed to the wheel to controller. So that is the purpose of wheel. So after wheeling, it's going to pass to the controller. Then controller, what it will do in the sense, it's going to update the model based on what are all the events it may receive. So even though for example 10 events are there, currently particular one or two events in silent phase may still occur in the sense. So it's going to pass or update over the model. So that is the purpose of this controller. So then model updates. So again it will repeat the same. Whatever it receives going to pass to the wheel. So the same thing will happen until the completion of the particular graphics process, particular event process. What is the purpose of these three things? So this diagram clearly shows how these three components are interacting with each other, model, wheel, controller. Next one is introduction of strings. So string in the sense, so it's also providing advanced components. So already we will discuss the AWD, abstract memory. But how it may differ from the swing in the sense, AWT has a heavyweight campaign, so it may consist of all the components like labels, buttons, checkbox, etc. But what is the special in the sense, it is providing the additional functionality over the label, additional capability over the existing components. That is the purpose of this thing. So class name also differ. For example, in button, not to create the button, in AWT usually use like the button. Class name is button, like button. But in case of using string, the button name is J button. So what is the difference between these two in the sense? Button already has the basic function like while clicking, it will do some operation. But in case of J button, it will do the like additional functions are there. So like handling the images as well as text, it's going to handle and display the same. So this is the purpose of the J button. Now the same way all the components, most of the components are available in this swing with advanced features. That is the purpose of this. So like so that is why this one has provides the powerful and flexible components than AWT. So on comparing AWT has more flexibility as well as powerful operations. For example, in case of usually text box, in the sense it can handle only the text. But in case of the swing text box means it may can handle also the images. So that is the advanced feature over the swing. So that is why this swing is preferred in this event-driven programming. So we'll see what are all the swing features are possible. So the first point is flexible look and feel. Flexible look and feel in the sense whatever the many fields, many components are there, we can select the highly lookable components. So lookable look and feel. So it may be easily exchangeable. I am fixing the particular component in the sense it will, I want to replace in the sense it will be very easy to change the same, and also it is easy to exchange the same. Whatever the components are, we can easily exchange from the Java container. Then lightweight component. This also considers lightweight component. While considering AWT, it has a lot of components, but while considering swing, it will be lightweight component because this does not depends on any native fields like previous. It does not require any the traditional components, so it's assets mode. So then simplified graphics. So in order to draw the paint over the particular frame, it will be very easy. That's why it is called as simplified graphics. Then similar behavior across the platform. So unlike AWT, it has dependent and all, it does not depend on the platform. It's an independent platform. So that's why it is behave the same behavior over different platforms. Whatever the platform we use, it will behave the like the same. Don't differentiate them for different platform, different model of systems. Then portable look and feel. Wherever the type of platform we use, it may be portable. Wherever we can copy and use the same. So that is why it's portable look and feel. So these are all because of these stations becomes lightweight process of lightweight components than the AWT components. Then finally, next one is new components like it's provided along with the existing components available from the AWT. It also provides some additional components like three tables, frame, text components, then scroll bars, etc. All the additional components along with some flexible features over the same. So this way its new components are introduced than the AWT. Then tool tips in the sense, when using a particular tool, it will raise the text tips. So if we struggle anything over by using these components in the sense, we can bring and rectify the same. Or if we finally, debugging support. So, any fault occur while using this component in the sense, it will provide the debugging support. Wherever we need, we may be better than the AWT.
Okay, so difference between AWT and string swings. AWT is an abstract number toolkit and swing components. So this table describes the difference between the abstract number toolkit as well as swing. So the swing components and AWT components. So first difference is the components, like AWT components are heavy weight components, because this includes everything, like whatever the process want to do over the Java, it will include everything. So that is, this is known as heavy component, and also platform dependent. Platform dependent in the sense, whatever the language we use, it is going to show only the corresponding tools which is available within this only. So that is why it is called as platform dependent. But in case of swing components or lightweight components, and also more features than the AWT components. So this is called as lightweight components and also platform dependent. So whatever the platform, whatever the software we use, it may allow the, say all the components to do the same. So that is why it is called as platform independent, and like this AWT is dependent. So based on the software used, it will show the score. Hide the particular components within available head. So that is the purpose of this is dependent one. This swing components are independent one. The second one is support delicate event models. Delicate event models in the sense it is related to the first point. So based on the software what we used, for example, Dell software, we have Micro MS. Microsoft system, so we have different platforms. So based on that, it's going to provide the corresponding events. But in case of, it's going to provide the common control, like YUM, PC, model, beep, and control. For whatever the display we want to do over the window, it's going to do the same, like model. It's going to create the model, then it will display through the beep, then control to the control stage. So these three things commonly allow the particular component display over the frame window. That is why it is called as MVC, model window, model beam control. So that is the second point. Third is static look and feel. Static look in the sense, while creating the particular component itself, we can change the whatever made over the same. So it is static one. But in case of swing swing type, we can do the dynamic changes over the same. Based on the previous condition, we can change the next subsequent component over the window with the help of the swing. So for example, dynamically we can change the background of the each and every component over the window. That is why it is called as dynamic look and feel. So that is different from this AWT. But it is not, it is static, like before, while creating the particular window component itself, we need to assign the background color as well as foreground color for the particular component. That is why this both are different. The same way, finally, this provide the tooltip tips for the components. So AWT provide the tooltip. Tooltip in the sense, we need any help over the particular component. In the sense, it does not provide the tool tips while using the same. Well, for example, while right clicking the particular tool, it will automatically show the help message. So, like that, this AWT does not provide this tool tip text over the components. But in case of swing components, it will provide the tool tip for the components. For example, whatever the components we want to drag over the frame window or place n number of components over the frame window, it will automatically provide the tool tip for the same. For example, we have various tools like buttons, checkbox, combo box in the sense, while clicking it, it will show the tips for how it may be operated, how it may be used, how it may be the size may be reduced or increased, or how to change the colors and all. So we can get the help over the this tool tip text. So these are all the major difference between the AWT component as well as swing component. So while considering this, swing component is more advanced than the AWT component, even though it is lightweight. So mostly topic, the swing components going to describe what are the most commonly used components nowadays. So there are numerous components out there, hundreds of thousands of components out there. So here we listed the most commonly used components here. So first one is J label. So this J label is a component which includes two constructors name like J label with empty constructor. Second one is J label with one argument constructor. So while using this J label, it will display like empty. You can have an empty label over the component, below. Second one is whatever the text you want to display, you can type here in order to take the caption over the label. So these are the two constructors majorly used in J label component. Next component is J button. It uses more number of constructor. I have defined two constructors here. J button with empty constructor, so empty argument. So if this does not provide any text over the button, but while using the second constructor while creating this button, in a sense, button with string some text. So we can print some text over the button. So that's what the string str represents. The next one, next component is J list. So J list includes two constructors. So empty constructors, not include any caption over the same. So the same way here, J list of string, in the sense it's going to include n number of strings within this list. Okay, so first constructor, this is empty constructor, it does not include any data within this. But in this, while using the second constructor, it include n number of list or item within this thing. So that is the purpose of thing. In future we will see how to select or deselect the list. The next one is J radio button. So this uses most commonly use these two constructors. First one is empty constructor, doesn't have any value while using this J radio button. While using two argument constructor, you can display some string with boolean B. So this boolean B represents whether it is enabled or not, whether it is selected or not, that is displayed here, player on off. So that is the two argument. Whatever the string want to display over the particular radio button, whether it may be selected or not, that is decided by this boolean B. The next component is J combo box. Combo box, in this sense, it includes these two constructors. Empty constructors, as usual, it does not include any caption over this. And also, while you passing the items over this, along with this combo box constructor, in the sense, it may include n number of items within this combo box. That is the purpose of this. It includes, for example, 5 or 10 or 15, whatever the objects and its items we want to add, we can add with this array or vector. That is the purpose of the same. The next component is checkbox. Checkbox, it also include two constructors. There are more number of constructors. These are the most commonly used constructors. The first one is MB. The second one is checkbox with the string and boolean. So string, in the sense, whatever the message you want to display as a caption, you can give here the boolean, whether it may be selected or not, whether it may be on or not. Check or not. That's why this boolean option is given here. These are all the two arguments over this constructor. The next component is J text field. It includes two constructors, J text field of in number. So how many characters it's going to display? So that is need to specify here. Number of characters within this particular text field. So this J text field of string, in the sense string comma numbers. How many strings? This first argument represent the number of strings to be displayed over the text field. Here number of characters. So character string, in the sense like word by word. Character, in the sense like each and every character. Like what character wise you need to display the number of characters, and which type of string you are going to present over this text fields. That is the difference between these two things. So here in the first constructor requires only the number of characters. Here the second constructor requires, you need to specify the strings, whatever the string you want to list as well as number of characters it includes. That is the difference between these two constructors. The next one is the J text area. So text areas, this is somewhat different from this text field. So text areas, it includes two parameters like number of lines, number of characters. So that is the difference between the J text field and J text area. Because J text field allows only one line in this text field, but text area may allow more than one lines. Like n number of lines it may allow. So that is the difference between the text field as well as J text area. So here we need to specify in the first constructor number of lines we are going to define within how many characters. Number of characters. The same way, the text constructor of this J text area includes three arguments like strings. Whatever the string we want to pass, then number of lines, then number of characters. So all these are included as this constructor called like J text area. So these two are the most important constructor available in the J text area. Now finally, J password field. So password field is the special type of component. This allows the string needs columns. So for password listens while you typing the password, you can't able to read that particular character. Whatever the character are inputted by the user, it cannot display directly. It will echo the same. Echo these as a special character like ASCII or something else. So that is the purpose of this J password field. So we need to define here what are the string we are going to pass, then how many columns. So these are all the parameters required for this J password field. So these are all the various components and its constructor within the string. So we will see what are the classes corresponding. What are the corresponding classes like string classes, most important classes available in the Java. So yeah, as well as components, there are numerous classes are there. Classes are available in the component class. Component class is a super class in the Java platform. So in that we are going to discuss about only the most commonly used classes corresponding to these components only we are going to discuss. The first one is J label class. So this class provides the facility to define display some text over the window. So for example, while naming, we need to provide the option like name, age, roll number, register number. We want to display. So in order to display the caption, this label class is used. Then text field and Java text area. So this day always thing in all the classes. So this comes under the J component. So this is J is added with each and every classes. So J text field as well as J text area. So these two are the fields. So here this text field allow only one line to display over this field. This text area may allow n number of lines with n columns allowed. So we can select based on your requirement. We can select the text field or text area based on our text may be selected. So it allows. Then J password field. So as like its constructor, J password field allows, it is the special type of class which allows the characters, but while typing it won't display directly. So it will display its echo character. Our most commonly used echo character is ASCII. The symbol is like this. Asterisk symbol you may use. The symbol, whatever the character you may type, it will display like asterisk. So that is the purpose of this password field class. The next one is J button class. So unlike our normal AWT button class, this J button class provides the facility to display text as well as image over the same. Image or icons you can display over the button class. So that is the purpose of this J button class. The next one is J class of state. The next class name is J radio button. So this class allows in attestates you can do only one selection over the items. So this will enable the particular, if it enable in the sense the state of this radio button is on, otherwise it may off. So it allow only single selection at a particular time. Then J list class. So it will include you can have n number of this, but it allows single as well as multiple selection. Unlike the previous two classes, this allows both. Like whenever you want the multiple selection, you can do the multiple selection, or else I am selecting only one selection in the sense, it will also allows the same. So that is the purpose of the list. The next one is Copo Box class. So it may be the combination of list and text field. List in the sense, it allows the number of items and you can select single selection. It will also allow the text field. Text field in the sense, at a time it will allow only one line to display over the same. So this is the combination of list, box and text field. So you can select the one item, it may display over the top of that component, and we can edit also. Whatever the item we want to add, I can edit and add within that. That is the purpose of the J Copo Box class. Then J panel class. So it may be the extension of J component class. Extension of this J component class. From this component class only it is extracted, and also it is also using the container class also. Container class, and whatever the component it may add, it uses the function called add. Using the add function, it is adding a number of component within this. So most of the its super classes, it extracting or using the more methods in order to handle the same. So that is the purpose of this J panel. So most commonly this is the this is using this case J components, functions and constructors. So these are all the various classes and also most commonly used in the Java programming within this swing classes. Topic is methods of component classes. Although the component is a class, which is major class in the Java programming, so it includes numerous classes, like thousands of classes. Because this is a super class in the Java programming, these are the most commonly used functions available with the same. So the first function, add function, whatever the components we want to add over the window, we can specify here, then add into the particular window object like frame or panel or container. So that is the purpose of this function add. The second function is set size. Set size, it includes two arguments like width and height. So we can set the size of that particular component with its width and height. So we need to specify, and we can enlarge the size also. So that is the purpose of this set size, used to setting the size of the particular component. The third one is set layout. So whatever the layout manager model we want, we can assign for that particular window. There are a number of layout manager like border layout, flow layout, grid layout, grid bag layout, like border box layout. So like that, n number of layout models are available. So whatever this layout we want to add, we can add. If it is none of the layout I want to put over that particular window, in the sense I can put like null. So null enables the none of the layout for that particular window. Then set visible. So defaultly this false, like it is false in the sense we cannot be able to visible that particular frame. In order to enable the frame and its components, we need to true over this set visible function. If it is true only, we can see the same. So these are all the most commonly used function while using the frame with its components. So next one is these are all the two ways to create that particular frame in order to add the components over it. The first type is creating the object of the frame. Directly you can create the object of the particular frame. The second one is by extending the frame from the particular class. Whatever the class I am creating, from that class I can extend this frame class. So these are the two ways I create the frame. We'll see the example, like a simple Java swing example.
example, here I have taken the button component to add over the frame. So button component add over the frame. So for that I have created the class like swing button, which is extended from frame. So frame is a super class for this swing button. So you can use or extract the features of this class frame, which is already available in the component class. So for that I have initially include the package like Java X dot swing. So already previously frame was created with AWP package, which is available java.awp. Here this is advanced concept over the window creation, so that this is available within Java X package. So that is why I have included Java X dot swing dot swap. So whatever the features available like packages function available in the swing, I can utilize it in this Java coding. So for that purpose only I have included this package, the keyword import. This class includes the main function. Then that I have created the J frame with the object F. With does not include any caption here, so it will display empty. This end with the semicolon. And also I am using one button like a J button with the object B with a caption click. So whenever it display over the frame, it will display with the caption click. So then set bounds. So this defines 100, 90 represent the x and y coordinates. 80 represent the width of the particular button. 60 represent the height of the particular button. So boundary of the particular button defines these four parameters. Then f add of b. So f represents the frame object, like or add. This function adds this button into the frame. So that is the purpose of the F object. Using this object only we can add the button to the frame. Then setting the size of the frame. F dot set size in the sense is going to set the size of the frame. Whatever the frame we are going to display, the size is like with the 400, height is 500. Then set layout. This function is used to set the layout, particular layout, but here it is null, so there is no layout manager over this frame window. Finally set this window. This enable the frame window to not to display or add the button over the same. So these are the various functions. So while executing this function, we will execute the output like this. The output of this program is like this. So this defines the frame window. Within that we have the button over the caption, whatever is displayed over the program, like click. So display over the frame. So like click. So it just defined while creating the particular button with the object. So this is the better example of defining the swing button within Java coding. The next program in Java program to create the sample J list. So the previous program is a sample about the button. So this program describes the how to create the J list over the frame. So for that initially we need to include the following packages like awp.event, awt, then Java X dot swing. So this is the advanced concept we are going to use. The same, that's why this was additionally added while comparing the previous examples. So the class name is swing J list. So this describes how to create the frame and how to add the J list along with the same. So for that I extended the J frame class for this new class. So here it was extended. So whatever the feature available this J frame, we can use the same. So this objects are created for J frame. Like F is the object for frame class. B is the list object for list. So these are the two objects was created. Then within the main function we need to define the object. So object includes the caption like frame with J list. Then swing in J list is include this object with this object with the name S. So this is the object of this class swing. class of J frame. So within the frame, J panel also included. So panel object A panel with the object B P. So this must be added within the frame. What if you want to use the frame in this sense, it must be added within the frame. Then one label is created with the caption. Caption like select the day of the week. The object name is L, which is created from the J label. Then one string is created. The string name is V, with empty parameter, empty square bracket. So it includes, it defines whatever the data is added, it will be stored within this big string. Like for example, week in the sense, 7 days of the weeks are added. All the days, Monday, Monday, Sunday, all the days are included. So whenever you use this object of this class string in the sense, it may be considered, you can access the all the days from this week when we use. So from this creating this is the object of the particular J list. This so within this have added this week. So we includes all the days of the week. Then this line is represent set selected index of 2. So selected index of 2 in the sense totally this week includes 7 days. So 7 in the sense this index always starts with 0. So 0 to 6 totally 7. So 0 to 6 7 in the sense with 2 represents. For example, Monday represents the 0, in the week of 0, week of 1, 2. So this 2, 2 represents the Wednesday. So while displaying the output, it is always defaultly Wednesday may be selected. If the index selected 1 in the sense, this represents 0, this represents 1. So Tuesday may be selected. If it is 4 in the sense, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the Friday must be defaultly will be selected while displaying the output itself, or defaultly Friday will be selected. So that is the purpose of the set selected index. So when displaying itself, when displaying the day or the list itself, will be defaultly selected. Then p dot add up. So this button is added to the panel. Then f dot add up. This panel is this panel p is added. So this panel is added to the frame. So that is the concept here. So because panel is the subclass of the frame, so we cannot able to add the frame into the panel. So panel is added to the add function to the frame. So that is the concept here. Then size of the window, size of the frame window is 500 like it, and height of the frame. Then with the function like show, it will be displayed over the frame. F dot show. So executing this function, it will show the whatever the component is specified in display over the frame. So output of this program is displayed over here. So output the frame of caption is frame with J list because we enable the particular J is here. So enable. So the name is frame with J list. We have a label which displays select the day of the week. We can manually select the particular day. But here has showing the day of the week. So this, with the help of the select function, select index, this defaultly selected as